University Casa Italiana Zerilli Marimò for the performance of the winners of the IBLA competition. As you know, IBLA is one of the longest standing traditions in the life of Casa Italiana. I think we were born more or less at the same time, and from the very beginning we started collaborating in a variety of different ways. As you know, our friends, the wonderful artists that participated in the IBLA competition, are having a big concert tomorrow night at Carnegie Hall. The concert is sold out, so if you don't have a ticket, you're very lucky to be here and at least to be able to listen and enjoy the performance tonight. As you know, the purpose of IBLA is to give visibility to these artists and to help them create their international reputation. The winners receive as a major prize this tour that Dr. Moltisanti and his collaborators organized for them in different parts of the world. So it's really a way to help these artists to break into the music world. And it's a great mission. The artists are from all over the world. It's an Italian prize in the sense that the competition takes place in Italy, but it's international under any other respect. And this is why we like it. And this said, without further ado, you all have your program. I would like to invite Dr. Moltisanti to tell us something about this year's edition. Enjoy. And if you want to go back to the program in probably 3-4 days, we'll have the full video recording of the concert on our website. Thank you and enjoy.
Thank you, Stefano, for your patience and help every time. And all of you for being here. It's 5 o'clock. I did not expect at all to find an audience. I thought it was going to be just 4 or 5 people. So thank you so much for coming so early. Now, I will try to give you a few details every time a performer comes out for each one of them. But as a general frame, Baronessa, grazie. As a general frame, prego. What we are doing with these performers is to give them, before they perform at Carnegie Hall tomorrow, to give them a sense of what America is all about. I'm Italian, and too many times I've heard in Europe, lots of people just saying, I hate America, but they don't know what America is. I would say most people don't know at all what America is all about. In my own experience, I mean, if you know New York, that's not America. If you know, to know America, you have to go through the belly of America, go through America, and then know New York. You may get something. It was my personal experience, and that's the way I learned. So what I'm doing with them is go through my same itinerary. I came with a scholarship here two years ago in North Carolina. In North Carolina, Virginia, New York gave me a lot of knowledge of what America is all about. And then there is Chicago, and then there is Boston, and then there is California, and there is Texas. Eventually you get a picture of what is the American soul. So what these kids have done now is perform in Arkansas, all over Arkansas. They must have had like 10 concerts in Arkansas with wonderful audiences, standing ovations after every performance. I was there myself, I just couldn't believe. Just the warm, warm audience. And from a church to a theater. Then they did North Carolina, Virginia. Now they are here for Casa Italiana to prepare for tomorrow's debut. They are very nervous because tomorrow scares everybody. It's sold out, so everybody is really with a sort of a fever. Some of them are rehearsing together and playing together only today, because some came from Italy yesterday, they're meeting today at Casa Italiana. So have a little patience. When you see something goes wrong, they're still working out some things for tomorrow. And when you like something, make them No, make them feel that you like it. If you don't, same thing, you can whistle. Okay, Tomasz Mostaczewski. Tomasz is from Poland, and we have had accordionists among the IBLA winners for many years now. You may remember having heard them before. And there is something that you will know tonight through this concert. Our performers love their art. They are not just good performers or big egos to show how good they are. There is something particular in the sequence of performances you have seen this year each one of them has a deep, deep love for music. And then they're also good. But the love for music is something that I'm usually to find in many musicians at the same time. Like, when you learn how to play an accordion, you don't say, wake up one morning and say, mommy, I want to learn accordion. Like, well, I can say, I want violin or I want piano. Like, in a school, you can say to a kid, you know, what you choose. Accordion usually is not around. For you to play accordion, you have to come from an environment, a family, a village that has an appreciation for accordion, that has a history of accordion. People play accordion together in a certain way. It's part of a culture. And within that love of the accordion, then comes a young kid, which it could be Tomas, and develops the love to the accordion to bring it to the very highest level of classical music, contemporary music, the way you're going to see tonight. So there is behind this, there is that you will hear specific depth of certain villages in Europe that you can imagine. I would not say what, but you can imagine what I mean this way. You find a program, very long, we're going to choose only one or two pieces in the order they are printed here. If you don't have programs, raise your hands, we're going to bring the programs to you. So first piece is Tomasz Ostrzejewski, accordion from Poland, Zolotaryov, Sonata number 3, the fourth movement.
Thank you.
Asian boy whose luggage was lost at the airport, so he has no clothes with him. No people forgive him. He's so adorable. No, something about him. The reason we invited him is that this past summer he was singing and playing. It was the most beautiful thing. Apparently his voice, this past 6 months, changed. So he doesn't want to sing anymore for us to play. So let's have him play. Maybe we convince him a little bit to try singing, because we don't care if the voice is not going to be the same. Quindi sto dicendo, intanto suoniamo. Poi se lei se la sente un po' dopo, provi anche a fare un po' di cantato, anche se la voce non viene fuori bene, non per niente, va bene? Allora prima intanto sentiamo Bach preludio and then solima toccata. When we have two pieces like this, we don't clap in between. Let him connect to the second piece in silence. Allora, questi due pezzi devi suonare senza applauso. Invece finisci il primo e continua con solima.
Thank you.
George, please come in. Yeah, you can take a seat. Do you think he loves music? Maybe yes, maybe yes. But still, we have to hear him sing. Allora, alla fine del programma cantavo. At the end of the concert, we ask him. But if you hear him sing, you have no doubt that he really loves it. Just amazing. Grazie. I mean, here is a lady that has shocked a lot of us. Now, I will be very quick, yeah, I hope I'm not disrespectful, but in order to play and sing, and we should, her will to sing has taken her to be a truck driver across the states. È una camionista che ha guidato attraverso tutti gli Stati Uniti. Ha fatto tutti i lavori possibili, pur di continuare i suoi studi e mantenersi. And also has survived a very serious brain cancer surgery. I mean, anything that could have happened to this young lady has happened to her. Still, she's here with what you're going to hear now, an incredible soul, and she has made us cry a few times. So, Audrey Soder-Ramsey, accompanied her from Lisa Pina from Finland, the great pianist, and they will sing Menotti, the Black Swan, one of the most dramatic pieces in the repertoire, and then Geisha in Summertime. Again, two pieces, no applause, we hold.
Needles break, the sun is buried on the stone.
we have a gorgeous Lyum wood. So in the second page, Lyum wood lists la variazione sul Don Giovanni di Mozart, una bella opera. Lyum wood, Franz Liszt, Don Juan.
Thank you.
And now, prego. Angelica Cirillo, and will be accompanied by Lisa Pimia from Finland. Bevi, pace mio Dio, forza del destino.
Oh. quite kind of original that I arranged for myself. Yes.
Ginastera, then Prokofiev, no clapping in between, and we see what happens. Thank you. always wants to play more, so I said, fine, that's the condition. No, he cannot ask for more. Just can't play anymore. Okay, prego. Now, behind the kid that good, there is also a good teacher, but there are also special partners. And during these days performing, I've seen the mother, very positive figure. If you remember, 2 years ago, the New York Times published a beautiful article about parenting these kids today. And there were the Asian type mother, the American mother, the French mother. Those of you who missed this article, it's really interesting and beautiful. In this case, we have a mother healthy, that has clearly a healthy relationship with the son. And he plays a lot, practices a lot, but he's not overwhelmed by the environment. He's well nourished, an interesting kid. And here we are, again, two pieces, no applause in between. You're going to hear like a full concert in this 8 minutes of music. She will start with Johnson talking and singing. I'm not telling you what it is, it's really something unique. And from there, I have asked her to finish with an Italian song. So Puccini, Sola Perduta Abbandonata della Manon Lescaut will finish, will be like an Italian gift for us after this amazing contemporary piece. Her name is Eija Räsänen, soprano, from Finland, and again our great pianist Liisa Pinia from Finland.
And oh.
Practice, and you never know whether they're, you know, playing while they're playing under pressure until there is this love for music comes in. And this happened to Ian, and we know because now he can never stop playing. He's always playing. He plays only what he likes, but still he keeps plays all the time. Then they find out that playing well, you know, makes them popular and all the girlfriends hang around. So you never know the fine line where the love for music, love for life, everything gets together and comes out this beautiful work that we'll hear tonight with Ian Miller. Elton John, when you ask Ian to warm up, a normal pianist will go and warm up at the piano. I'm sure Jason warms up at the piano. Ian runs around the block twice. He warms up and then he plays. That's to say how unusual we are as a kid. Okay, Ian Miller, Elton John, Funeral for a Friend. Patrick Stravinsky, Scarlatti e Sonata. And we hear this beautiful Scarlatti Sonata on the accordion, just marvelous, followed by Kuzhakov. So, prego. Prego. So again, Patrick Stravinsky from Poland, Scarlatti, Kuzhakov. No clapping in between.
Thank you.
Jeff Sieri, pianist, composer, half Sicilian as well. And David, usually the audience splits into half hates him, half loves him. So at the end, you can boo and clap at the same time. That's fine. He's a great musician and knows how to take it. It's our pleasure to be here. Dave Sieri, Dream Passé. John McCarthy, Mike Brown, Ruben Rudding, and Ruben Codelli. Thank you. seats. And be prepare yourself now with the last page. Cast your vote. Choose the one musician you like. We would like to narrow down the choice to one musician. If you can, choose only one. And if you don't have pencils, we're going to try to pass around some pencils. One, if we can pick up one. Now, these are... These are, last but not least, you're gonna have fun with these two guys. Samuel Fried from Switzerland and Yuka Munehisa from Japan. Do you need the other bench? No?
Thank you. Thank you.